it's a big data platform given by Google, and it's available to everybody. For Google BigQuery, we must need to log into the Google Cloud platform, and then what we can do, we can go and click on BigQuery, where you'll be redirected to a new page, and in that page you'll see that you can have options like compose query, query history, job history. So query history and job history is something which will show when you are running the queries to find out data out of the data set. There are some publicly available data sets also there which you can use in case if you want to build your own data set. You can come to my first project section, and there you can click on the drop down and create a new data set. But right now we will just use the publicly available data set, and from there on we will start picking the data in Power BI. So in Power BI, to connect to the Google BigQuery, we go to query editor, the data source, and here in the search box we type big to locate Google BigQuery. We click there, click on connect. So it's still under development phase, so we're still on the beta level. Now let's wait for it to go to the new phase. So after some time you get the sign in window. In the sign in window you can sign in using your Google ID. So you'll get your sign in window like this, where you have to add your Google ID. Since I have enabled phone authentication, so I'll be redirected into that. We'll wait for the login. So once we pass the password and we are redirected to a new page where it asks for authentication from Power BI, we'll just click on allow and it goes to the new page. On the navigator you get the Google BigQuery option which you can expand. Since we have not created any data set, so we will not get that option, but we can get the publicly available data set which we can use for our reporting purpose. So I'll just expand the first one, BigQuery public data. Now we can use any of the source, whether base wall or anything. So let's expand base wall. Here we can use all the three tables. So for now we will not use direct query, we'll just use the import mechanism. So since it takes time to load, there are huge data, let's